Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. This video has been inspired by your question on YouTube and Facebook. With this video, I would like to help in spreading the wise and knowledgeable words of Michael Mann, who is, in my opinion, a very valid climate scientist. The breathtaking damage and destruction and the loss of irreplaceable ecosystems are hurtful and awful to see, but this is the most appropriate time to talk about climate changes, because this isn't something so far in our future. Here in Australia, we're dealing with it right now. The first question that comes to mind, if there is a link in between anthropogenic climate change and this bushfire emergency. Well, to put it easy, you take unprecedented heat, you combine it with unprecedented drought, which obviously means that there is a lot of fuel ready for the fires. You put those things together and you're gonna have the sort of unprecedented emergencies that we have now. At the moment, there is a 45 degrees Celsius air mass that has been doing circles around Australia for at least the last couple of months. It's usually the case that a monsoon through develops north of Australia and comes down into Australia, breaking the heat mass up. But the monsoon had not developed, apparently because of colder waters in the Indian Ocean. Cooler water means that there is lesser humidity in the air, and that contributes to the drought that we are seeing right now. But there are also those so-called dynamical mechanisms like El Niño, for example, or the Indian Ocean Dipole that reflect the natural variability of the system. And this is on top of the signal of climate change. So sometimes, like in this case, it will add to the climate change signal already present, adding heat and drought, as in this case, as we're seeing right now. But even in the absence of changing climate dynamics, whether or not the Indian Ocean's dipole is getting stronger due to the climate change or not, the basic factors are the heat and the drought. And this is why we are seeing unprecedented wildfires. To answer to my subscribers, no, I don't have the power to make it stop. I don't have a button to press to stop the fires. Even admitting that my machine works, this situation is a billion times bigger than what I could face with them, hypothetically. This kind of situation, this kind of catastrophic situation, needs to be prevented, not cured. As we're seeing these days, there is very little we can do once it flared up. If all the Ighina's theories proved to be true, in my opinion, something of that scale would need dozens of Ighina labs disseminated along the whole East Coast and years of dedication in trying to maintain a stable weather system. But even that is no solution. We need to bring our carbon emissions down. It doesn't matter what the historical pattern has been. Right now, we need to ramp down our carbon emissions by a factor of 2 within 10 years if we want to avert the worst impact of climate changes. Each nation has its role in creating this problem. Some countries have had a bigger historical role on it, but the cumulative carbon emissions that is creating this climate change is mainly due to industrial countries. So they should take a leadership role and set an example for the developing countries, which otherwise they will take their turn into this carbon rush. Is this the new normal? Well, it's worse than that. The new normal implies that we settle into this new state. And then we just need to figure out how to adapt to it. This is more like a ever-moving baseline. Here, it will just get hotter and drier, and the fires, they will just get more damaging. This This is just a taste of what to come if we don't act.
Jasper, put the blanket up.